We shall now discuss about the integer data type. The integer data type along with characters is very, very frequently used in C programming. So it is really important to have a good conceptual understanding of the integer data type. So just to refresh our memory, integers are used to hold both positive and negative numbers, provided they do not have any fractional or decimal part in them. Now, integer numbers, as I said, can be both positive or negative. That means signed indicates it can be both positive or negative. But if an integer is unsigned, that means it can only hold zero or positive numbers. Now, the convention used for representing signed numbers is quite old. The way it is used to represent in binary system is, as you are aware of it, anything in computers is represented in terms of ones and zeros. So suppose I have to represent plus 1 in base 10 system using just 4 bits. So what I will do is I will use the leftmost 1 bit to indicate the sign of the number, and I'll use the remaining 3 digits or 3 bits to represent the number. So this is plus 1 and the 0 indicates that this is positive. Now if I have to represent minus 1 in base 10, all that I do is I make this bit as 1, indicating that this one is minus 1. So this leftmost bit is also known as the sign bit. Now the problem with this sign number representation is, if I have to represent minus 0 and plus 0, which is actually meaningless, for minus 0, it will represent this as 1. For plus 0, it will represent this as 0. So now you have a problem. 0 has two different representations. So in order to overcome the problem with this particular representation, we use something called as 1's complement, or the very most commonly or popularly used 2's complement method. Now when we have a positive number, if it is a signed integer and if it is a positive number, in that case this bit will be 0. Otherwise, if it is negative number, this bit will be 1. Now just to refresh, unsigned numbers means 0 or positive numbers only. Now the integer data type on most modern machines has 32 bits, or it is represented using 32 bits. Let me explain what I mean by the number of bits. Suppose I have, let's say, 8 bits to represent a number. In that number, if I can only represent 0 or positive using 8 bits, then I can represent number from 0 to 255, and the formula is 2 raised to n minus 1. So this is an example of an unsigned 8-bit integer. But suppose I had to use 1 bit for the sign, then out of the 8 bits, only 7 bits will be available for me. So if I have to represent both positive and negative numbers using 8 bits signed representation, then the range will be minus 128 to 0 to plus 127. Although there will be a total of 256 numbers on both the sides, here I am only representing 0 or positive numbers. Here I am representing both positive and negative numbers. This thing is known as the range of a number. This is also the range of unsigned 8-bit number is 0 to 255. The range of 8-bit signed is minus 128 to plus 127. Now sometimes you may have extremely large or big integers. Then instead of the normal int, you have something called as the long int. Similarly, you may have a smaller integers like age of a person. So instead of having the normal int, you have something called as a short int to save memory space. Now when you declare an integer variable in a computer, suppose you go ahead and you end up declaring an integer variable. So when you declare an integer variable, let's say I say something like this. I say int I. By default, this is I is assumed to be a signed integer. Now these words short, signed, unsigned, which I'll be showing you a few examples, are known as modifiers or qualifiers because they modify the behavior of the integer data type. Now, just to give you a little idea, C99 has introduced a new type of an integer called as long int or unsigned long int. What it says is the size of this type of variable must be minimum 64 bits. It is used for storing very, very large integers. The range of signed long int is minus 2 raised to 63 to 263 minus 1, Why you're not having 64 is because 1 bit is used for the sign. In case of unsigned long int, the range is 0 to 264 minus 1. Now, examples of declaration of integer variables are as follows here. So here what I am doing is I am saying unsigned short int age. This int is actually optional when I am using it with short. What this means is age can store a value between 0 to any positive side based on the limit of int. Short int salary, this is a signed int. It can store salary which is both positive and negative. This is again a cost which is a signed integer which can store both positive and negative. This is a short int, this is a normal int. The size of short int will generally be much less than int. Suppose int is 32 bits or 4 bytes. This one int is 32 bits or 4 bytes. More than likely short is going to end up being about 16 bits or 2 bytes. This is unsigned int population. That means population can be 0 or positive, cannot be negative. Long int income, that means this is an integer type of variable having a large capacity, both positive and negative numbers can be stored. This is again a long, but it's an unsigned long, and variable is my salary. It can only have be zero or positive. Now you need to understand these words like short, long can just be used without using the int keyword along with it. So instead of saying short int salary, I could have simply said short salary. So instead of saying long int income, I could have simply said long income. That's what it really means. Now, to give you some examples of decimal constants or decimal integer constants or integer constants, the reason we are calling them decimal is because base 10 is also referred to as decimal system. So if I have to refer to decimal integer constants or integer constants in the base 10 representation, these are examples. These are examples of octal numbers. If I precede anything with a 0, it is an octal number. If I precede an integer with 0x, it's a hexadecimal number. Now the moral of the story is avoid mixing any of these octal, hexadecimal, base 10 in the arithmetic operations. Don't use multiplication of an octal with a decimal with a hexadecimal. You will be confused as to how the process is happening or what is the final result. When you are trying to debug, it will turn out to be a nightmare for you. These numbers, octal and hex, are extremely useful when you are working on bitwise operators or doing low-level programming. So we'll deal with them as and when we come to those kind of problems.